Hey, yeah, sorry, you're gonna hear ambient noise. I have a fan pointed at me and one across from me, along with an air conditioner vent going. We have incredibly high humidity today with, you know, I think we're somewhere in the 80s today, but the humidity makes it feel like we're in the upper 90s. It's just very suffocating. So I'm sorry in advance. what I have today is a little bit of a haul. For the most part, prior to today and my Saber hobbies, these were the only graph lights that I own. And I had bought one of these as a gag, because this one in incredible condition, I got for like $20. Didn't come with this top portion here, but I sought after this and I found it. It's the entire flash bulb, the flash dish. I just kept this because it looked like a great emitter piece to do a custom saber one day. This guy I found on eBay like a year ago, and for those who don't know, this guy right here, this one blemish, this is the dude, this guy sits in Luke Skywalker's X-Wing. I think it's like a guidance computer of some sort, but it's not kish-bashed, it's just, there's a ton of stickers that you put on this, so I wouldn't be defacing this guy in any way. Because it's just adhesive. Yeah, it's just stickers. There's a guy out there. I got to look and see if he still has the kit. The decal kit. But yeah, the thing I've been waiting for were to find these black clamps. The actual black clamps. And these are it. Somebody had told me to take these guys and just spray paint them. I've spray painted aluminum before. I believe this is aluminum, because it's not heavy. I don't believe anything magnetizes to it. Let me see. I got a magnet on this flashlight. The screw, yes, but not this. So it's a steel screw. I'm not going to do that. So I found the proper brackets on this Graflex Junior. I bought two Graflex lights. A friend of mine just recently gave me a Graflex 2.25 by 3.25 camera, and he didn't have a flash with it, so he gifted me. He found this 3-cell and gifted it to me with it. It was incredibly generous of him. You didn't have to do that. But that being said, this looked crazy on it. It's just too small. So I found a junior. I got like for 20, I got the junior upstairs with it. It's like $20. This guy was, I think, 30. But these clamps I've seen go for like 35, 40. And once they're there, they're gone. You know, they just get swallowed up. So I caught it in time, and I'm going to take these guys off and throw them into this guy. It's really weird week for Graflexes for me, because I got to get a measuring tape, but I'm pretty sure I have a 4x5 Graflex now that I picked up at my local antique store that I have been I've been checking that place out on and off for like the better part of 5 years, and man, oh man, was I looking for that one. You know, I've been looking for a Graflex just sitting in one of these stores, and I never found it. I've seen some really ratted up Highlands. I've seen some really ratted up Collarts, I think is how you pronounce them. I mean, gnarly. Like, just not taken care of, sitting in a garage or what have you for years. Years. So, you know, to me, to find that flashlight, excuse me, that flash, that camera. I'm thinking of the flashlight I just used to magnetize. That was a feat. A rather heavy feat. So last week I got the two by, I'm gonna call it the 2x3, even though it's a middle ground version. I got the 2x3 sometime last week. Out of the blue. I wanna say it was like last weekend. And I was like, my friend just walks in with it and she blows my mind. I'm like, you know, I'm working at I got a little part-time gig at a camera shop. And the main guy who's managing it just like throws it at me. He's just like, this is for you. It used to be my father's. I have no use for it. You know, I saw him the week prior and I was telling him how I've been looking for that camera. And, you know, I want one for my students. And I told him that I'm a lightsaber guy. I don't want to mess around with my vintage. He had no idea that people do that. You know, that people like us pick them up and then mess with them. And he was horrified by it when I told him. And I go, I understand it's horrifying. They would say it's a labor of love for our hobby. And he's like, yeah, but my hobby is getting decimated. And then, you know, I showed him some Romans and stuff. And that kind of eased his angst. And, you know, I fell for him in that moment. I really did. But he saw that I was genuine about trying to keep a camera in my collection. And he gave it to me. And I, to that, you know, that really, I'm going to keep it like, this is how it would go in a camera, right? This one, as you can see, this is like idealized. But this guy here, this guy needs some cleaning. This guy was measured out for the 2x3, and it was sitting really weird. I actually got, again, I got two of these, one in black and one in silver. The one in silver is upstairs. It complements it so much better than this giant one. The only thing I didn't know is that these juniors don't have buttons, so there's no place to light the bulb. So I guess you need a wire for that, and I guess that's what the synchronizer is for. I don't know. I don't know camera terminology too well. I'm sort of in training, but yeah. At the end of the day, this guy sits on top of Luke's X-Wing. I don't know if the spacing's correct. It's eyeballing it. But this to me, until I get the decals, this is pretty much complete. Not that I need the decals, but, you know, it's good enough. This thing will sit on my desk as if I'm going forward in space or whatever. I'm pretty sure it's at this facing Luke. Yeah. Pretty funny. It's just amazing. All the cameras, the kit bashing, all of that. Just amazing. Just amazing way things happen. So that's it. Thank you. Appreciate it.